Hello everybody, there's a Rock Gaming here, and we are back for another round of Robocop Rogue City. Not to this long hiatus, feels good to be back. So let's see what we have for us in this episode. So quiet.
What's the big idea?
Piece of junk taser blew the fuse when I tried to charge it.
Again? Really? Nope, it's not letting me.
Just keep following the road.
But the road ends here.
What was that? Oh, you're breaking up.
Am I? I'm hearing you clearly.
Oh my god, what a lemon.
You two seem to be enjoying yourselves.
I'm just having a little fun with our fellow dispatcher.
Don't worry, I'm sure the kid has a sense of humor. It's just a little blue hazing. And he's an OCP stooge anyway.
You're not going soft on us, are you, Murphy?
OCP is never to be trusted.
That's what I'm saying.
Yep.
You know that he runs to Becker with a stack of papers every time you two talk, right? He's a rat.
We're just looking out for you, Murphy.
Yeah, still in the dark. Are you part of my objectives? Nope. Okay. You guys are in the dark. Bye. Alright, let's see what we're gonna do next.
Alright. The situation at the bank was contained in a relatively smooth fashion. So what did we learn from it?
When it's their money on the line, OCP will send Robocop, the entire SWAT team, and a bunch of Ed 209s that actually work.
Anything else?
Wendell Antonowsky no longer deals with the Street Vultures.
That's right. There's been a rift in their midst, and I want to know why.
Spike has proven to be talkative, under suitable conditions.
That's why I want you all to head to the city and do some actual police work. We need to find Spike. The attack on OCP Bank was a desperate move. I'm sure there's plenty of theories floating around. So we need to listen to what the streets are saying to find where the vultures are hiding.
I know someone versed in street talk.
Talk to him. And, oh, I almost forgot. Murphy, once you're downtown, the old man wants to meet with you.
Oh, the old man himself? What an honor.
Yeah, he's the closest Detroit has to real-life royalty. Maybe for saving him all that money, he'll knight you or something.
Enough! Head downtown, ask around, and most importantly, find Spike!
Alright. Find Spike.
Robocop! Over here!
Crap.
You wouldn't want to make the mayor of Detroit wait, would you?
That depends. Are you gonna sell out to Nuke again?
May I help you, Mr. Mayor?
Oh, it's me who's gonna do the helping. You know John Mills, I presume? The OCP puppet who's gunning for my seat as mayor? I've heard from a reliable source that he's planning to make you the highlight of his election bid. Judging by your expressive face, he hasn't talked to you about it yet, huh? That's what I figured. What a slimy bastard. Using your image to influence the good people of this city, and without your consent? That's clearly something that I would never do. But you know that I've always appreciated what you're doing for our city, right? So the real question is, what are we gonna do about it together?
Screw it. Rebel.
I will not let OCP take over this city.
I knew you'd understand. I need to go. Campaign season is busy, but let me leave you with one word of advice. Whatever you do, make it clear that you are not siding with Meals. You can be sure that they'll twist your every word and use it against you. That's what OCP does. Thanks for the talk, RoboCop. Say no to Delta City. Vote for the neighborhoods. Vote for Kuzak.
Yeah, Kuzak.
RoboCop is getting a face-to-face with the old man himself. I'd tell him all about how the OCP is fucking us over.
No, you wouldn't. You wouldn't say a word if you actually met him.
Why? Did you meet him?
Last year's Thanksgiving parade. I was part of a column dedicated to protecting his dog.
What? How come this is the first time I'm hearing this? Officer Ramirez, a licensed dog walker.
Shut up, Kaplan.
Yeah. I like these dialogues. Makes the world feel alive. They're just... NPCs are just...
Shiny. Got a job for you.
As I was saying, I like these dialogue, random dialogues. It makes this world feel alive instead of just people standing still, doing absolutely nothing. Alright, what do you want?
How are you feeling after the incident at the bank?
Who gives a shit? I heard that you're heading to the city. Once you're out there, I want you to check one apartment for me. There's suspicion of domestic terrorism and corporate espionage, so expect a warm welcome.
Should I assume hostility from the suspect?
I assume you'll find sensitive data there. Look for it thoroughly and make sure it comes straight back to my hands. Tenement across the street from the arcade, apartment 12. Now go, I've got to prepare for a meeting. And remember, if you won't take care of it, another cop will have to. Another cop that isn't quite as resistant to deadly surprises as you are.
Yeah, you're gonna send the rookie, aren't you? Alright, time to save the rookie. Okay. I forgot. Why not? Then let's go with firepower. All right, I'm gonna be around. Okay, now we're going. Secondary objective. Alright, let's see what you want me to do here.
Someone on the staircase.
Bridge. Oh no. Sticking there this week. Storage bill. Pick up cat food. Take the fishmonger's statement. Okay. Ooh. Don't mind if I do. Secret passage. Storage unit, client 80-94-E3-1, storage number 17, storage machine address. Project 10 with tax. Okay. Ooh, we upgrade. Big ID. Yes.
So OCP is ordering you to break into the apartment of a reporter they don't like? Any comment before I write a story on that?
I am here to investigate domestic terrorism.
OCP sent you to my safe house because they want to know what I have on them after the bank incident.
I assume there is more if you cannot store everything here. I found a rental bill for a locker in a storage facility.
Make up your mind. First you let me go at the bank, and now, when I'm actually starting to figure out what the OCP scam is all about, you show up and ruin this. Do you want to help OCP avoid liability?
Yeah.
Show me your evidence, and I will make the culprits regret their deeds.
So far, you're just making my road to the goal harder. It turns out I was right. That thing that OCP plans to do with charging residents of Old Detroit with additional costs, it is a loophole. It will lead to the illegal expulsion of thousands of people if you help OCP silence me.
Explain.
Not so fast. I need to be able to trust you first. At the bank, you proved that you are more than just a tool programmed to obey OCP, but now, the stakes are higher.
What is it that you expect?
Since you're here, I fully expect someone from OCP to go and check my locker. I need to protect what's inside, but there's a meeting I need to keep an eye on. Too much depends on it.
I will not be involved in the smuggling of contraband.
There's nothing illegal about my request. I need only one box from there. The one with the inscription Bakery on the corner. The rest you can leave to OCP to pick up. I need to just spring clean my out-of-date documents anyway. Call me once you secure the box.
Okay. Let me just level up. Yeah. And away we go. Alright.
Are you like me? Are you a true environmentalist? Do you appreciate the majestic beauty of nature? And do you feel helpless knowing that every year more and more species are becoming extinct? Because let's face it, there's nothing that can be done. So, you know what they say. If you can't beat them, join them. Last Chance Safari. See all the endangered species before it's too late. Last Chance Safari is the largest collection of near-extinct species on the planet. So hurry, get them before it's too late. Additional fee to use your personal rifle may be required.
I knew it. I knew it. You hunt them. You don't watch them behind a glass door or glass wall.
Man, it's RoboCop.
So what? We're just sitting here enjoying the moment. Nothing suspicious. Right, officer?
Shouldn't we give the fellas the signal?
We should just shut up and smile like the exemplary citizens that we are.
Yeah. Behave. Oh, you're gonna say hello to my BFF called Otto 9.
Are you lost, officer? I can show you the exit if you want.
Oh, bring on the ambush.
Trouble with the lock.
Seems that I forgot the key, but,
You will tell your story at the station.
Are you sure you have enough seats in your car to take us all?
Dead or alive, you're coming with me.
If you do not come quietly, I will not need any.
Look out!
Bad guys, they'll never learn. Unless you have that 50 cal like them bikers had. You ain't punching my skin. Locker. See if we can find some collectibles. Well, that was weird. Just evidence and the painting. Okay. Well, hello.
Well, well, well. Looks like Mr. Becker was right. You're up to something behind his back. These things are supposed to go to Mr. Becker, I reckon.
What will interest Becker is in locker number 17. The contents of this box are none of OCP's concern.
I'll have to tell Mr. Becker that you have not given us all the material.
I assure you that it will end up worse for you than for me.
Move it, fellas.
I'm guessing you have my stuff. Did OCP arrive at the party?
They tracked my location.
because they trust you so much. Speaking of which, the box. What if I lied about it? Did you ever think of that? There may be a bomb inside or the head of my sworn enemy. Do you want to know what's inside?
If there is evidence of a crime, I would like to know it.
Police officer, first and foremost.
Yep.
In the box are my personal belongings. Letters, memorabilia, things that actually matter to me. When you become too tough to hit directly, the scum will try to get to you through your loved ones.
I understand.
So we have even more in common. Once OCP takes care of my old documents, I'll have the space to deal with the Delta City issue and help the people of Old Detroit. You've helped them already, though. Thank you. Ronnie's grocery. Leave the box there.
Well, that explains the cat food. Here the cats. Oh, it might have been you. Oh yeah. No jukebox to destroy.
What do you mean, a dollar? It's $23.50.
I have Samantha's belongings.
Yes, I'm glad you're helping her. Without that girl, OCP would put us all on the street. Still might. They did a number on a lot of families, hers included. Samantha's mother took it worst. But that's not a story for me to tell. Anyway, leave the box in the back, next to the cat food. She's supposed to pick up everything tomorrow.
I just slid to Samantha's mother, Miss K. Ortiz. They're accusing you of false. Also find evidence because they wanted to discredit you, but I don't believe them. None of us do. We understand that the media and OCP is one of the same. You're actually, well, help others. Actions will help others understand it too. So don't let them silence you. Someone has to speak out on our behalf. Someone must stand up against them. Alright, old man. Let's see what you want. More gutsy that you showed up. Oh wait, you're not the old man.
Hey you! The old man is waiting for you upstairs. This entrance to the building is off limits. You have to use the stairs.
Ah, so this is where Delta City's supposed to be, eh? I take it all the other all the families were moved to, what's the word? Rehab? If you watch Robocop 3, you know what I'm talking about.
The old man's waiting. So, it's true what they say. You do have some kind of defect.
Your mother. When she gave birth to you. Oh!
Oh, it's good to see you, my boy. Leave us. I want to talk to him in private. You have to excuse me for not getting up. I'm in a rather unfortunate state. You did exceptional work at the bank. I want you to know that I am deeply grateful for your service to OCP and the city of Detroit. See, I grew up in this very apartment, or what's left of it. It used to be a thriving neighborhood, nothing like what you see right now. I always dreamt of turning it into the most prosperous district in the city, a new heart of Detroit. Can you imagine? Or do you think it's just an old fool's pipe dream?
An old fool's pipe dream. But I'll just keep that to myself.
I agree with all city improvement plans that have the citizens' well-being in mind.
glad to know you approve. Delta City's construction is about to start. Finally, the old and frail will be replaced with the new and strong. Decay and death are terrible things. You lose everything you worked for your entire life. But I don't have to tell you what that's like. It really makes me wonder, has the time you spent in that armor been a burden to you?
Yeah, that one.
The only burden it causes is to criminal scum.
I admire your confidence. The real reason I've summoned you here is because I'm worried. I'm aware of your instability problems, and it's not a matter that we can overlook. That's why I've requested to have people look after you. Tell me, how are you finding your evaluations with Dr. Blanche?
I'll just be nice to the old man.
I am happy to comply with any activity that improves effectiveness.
You're a good sport. I can imagine it's not a pleasant experience, but I can't express how much I'd like you to keep at it. I'm sure that becoming a liability is the last thing you'd want. Am I right?
That is correct.
Now we've reached an understanding. Tell me, is there anything I could do to put your mind at ease?
Give me a bigger gun. Oh, man. Yep, I'm just gonna do this. Close my eyes. 1, 2, 3.
My fellow officers worry about OCP's intention regarding their work.
Really? I'll have a word with Becker. Perhaps some new equipment would boost their morale.
It would be appreciated.
I have to say, you brought a lot of hope into this old man's heart. Now, excuse me. I'm not supposed to exert myself too much. Doctor's orders. And you can't argue with them. Take care of yourself. After all, the peace of Detroit depends on your well-being.
Roger. Robocop, over and out. Oh boy, hopefully we still can recover.
Hey Murphy, are you done with the old man's tea party? Remember to get back in touch with your informer. See if he has any info that could get us back on the biker's lead. Spike is still out there.
OCP wants to raise towers and blast and steal? Go ahead! Just not where we live.
Third movie has to say something about that. Okay, before we talk to Pickles, let's get this part over with. Game of hide and seek. Here I go.
Give me my money, you damn machine! Hey, this ADM won't give me my money. Can you do something about it?
Ooh. Engineer, come on. Sorry. What's this?
Thank you.
coin into the fountain?
Waste of money, honey. Someone will steal it before you make a wish.
Ouch. Ain't wrong.
Attempts to reproduce the last living blue-nosed platypus ended in failure after two remaining animals killed each other because of badly matched aphrodisiacs.
Oh. Independent News, number 15, is issue Checkmate, Why Allies Taught Us to Play Chess and Why You Should Always Be Learning. Theory of Chess Players Playing in the Park. Poison Plants. Aliens are poison plants in the city. They will soon will as the fountain spreads deadly bacteria. In messages, the mayor's election is a smokescreen. Get special glasses that will let you read the election posters are really saying. Okay, good to know. Hello.
Littering is against the law.
It's an act of revenge. I was loyal and she betrayed me.
Trouble in a relationship is no excuse for littering.
What? I mean my boss. She fired me after all these years, so I'm spreading confidential papers. Let everyone know the fraud her company is up to.
Since I'm already screwing over OCP.
You can go, but remember, revenge results from weakness. Forgiveness requires strength.
Yeah, sure. Have it your way.
One down. Let's find the next one. Well, hello, hello. Shame. Number 3. Is that you?
You are committing an act of vandalism.
Yeah, did the guy from the poster send you?
Compliance with the law has no political affiliation. I have to issue a ticket.
You are suppressing my right to express my opinion. I am a political martyr!
Law's a law, regardless of political stance.
I'm in the right place, but I can't see my FTO anywhere. Could I have his name, please? Over.
Sure thing. It's Officer Rat. He should be in one of the dumpsters. That's the only place he belongs, if you catch my drift. Over and out.
Right. So much for my field training.
Hold up. Oh, that's not cute. What do we have here? Shame. Okay. Here. Now I can help the old man with the ATM problem. What do we have here? Smoking.
Smoking is dangerous, not to mention illegal.
I don't give a shit about either.
Well, in that case,
you must suffer the consequences.
No one in this country values independent thinkers anymore.
Independent thinkers. Fine, go ahead, blow yourself up. Okay, can help you, old man.
Hey,
You're saving my life. Finally, I got something to buy a nuke with.
Well, I'll be damned. I got suckered. Just like that couch. You're the last one to find. It was a long ass time to find. Shame on you.
Entering the fountain is strictly prohibited.
But I'm not even fully in, just my feet.
Regardless.
You will have to pay the total value of the ticket.
Oh, this is so unfair.
And no, there's like an ocean. You could just put your feet in the ocean. You'll get a ticket. Okay. Then I have to talk to the rookie.
Officer Washington, I will be your field trainer for today, requesting readiness confirmation.
Yeah, thanks for the offer, but maybe the others are right. I might not really be cut out for field work.
Ask yourself, do I have the will to clean the streets of Detroit of unrighteous individuals?
Yeah. As a matter of fact, I do. Officer Washington reporting for field training.
Good, you have your body armor on. Well done. What about the rest of your gear? Service pistol?
Got it.
Spare ammunition?
Check.
Duty light?
Never part with it.
Good job. Preparation is the most important. So is knowing your surroundings. Are you familiar with this area?
Isn't this the part of the city where it gets really busy, like, all the time?
Police!
I think that answers my question.
Please! I need your help!
Set the radio to my channel and follow me.
Roger that!
An officer needs to be confident. Straight back, sturdy walk, together with a clear and unshaking voice.
Girl, I'm ready. Mr. Raider's back. That's why I'm talking like this.
Officers, thank God you're here. I really need your help. What happened is...
When responding to a request for aid, the first thing is to introduce yourself to the potential victim. Watch and learn. I am Officer Murphy. How do you do, madam?
Well, to tell you the truth...
The second thing is to reassure the victim of their safety. Madam, you do not need to be afraid anymore. We are here to help you.
Yes, but it's not about me.
The third thing is...
I'm quite familiar with the field training manual, so if you don't mind, I'll take over. Ma'am, could you please tell us what happened?
It's my cat, Fortune. He's missing. He's my biggest treasure. I can't lose him.
Do you have any idea where he might be?
The only place I can think of is the basement. I've also heard some ruckus coming from downstairs today, but the lights aren't working and my eyesight's not so good anymore.
Is it okay for us to investigate the basement?
Yes, it makes an excellent opportunity for low-light training. Let us proceed downstairs.
Awesome. Look down there. Cat has that name for a reason. He really brings fortune. So don't you come back without him.
Turn your flashlight on.
Right.
Duty light can be advantageous, but it can also be a liability. Keeping it close to you creates a clear target for the violators. It is good practice to hold the duty light away from your body.
I don't remember reading that in the field manual. Did you get it from a different book?
No, from experience.
I was helping to rescue a damsel in distress. I guess a cat will have to do. Something to keep that voice going. But after hearing it's a cat, I deflated. Like a pufferfish.
Clear.
Hey, I think I just saw the cat. You think I should try to remove these planks?
Go ahead.
Wow! I didn't know I had so much strength in me.
You will never know until you try.
Yep.
What was that?
Paint?
Ah, man, I walked into a mess. Now my shoes are covered in strawberry jam.
When chasing a suspect, do not rush headfirst. Take blind corners as wide as possible. Cuts down on being surprised. Fugitive has left a trail. This time, pace yourself. Do not get out of breath during a foot pursuit. You will need stamina to engage the fugitive later.
Oh, looks like he stopped by the spilled paint can.
Suspect might be intoxicated.
Kids who gave their cat stomach medicine to make it loopy.
Is there a moral to that story?
Cats are susceptible to substance misuse.
Shh! I heard something.
I think it's coming from the piano.
Oh, I thought it was coming from back here.
That cat must be hiding inside. Let me lure it out.
Go ahead.
There it is! It's escaping! Darn it!
Go for it.
It went through here, but that's a very narrow passage. Let's try the door.
You could squeeze in. Bridge.
It's locked, but I can try to squeeze through that gap.
Bingo.
Go ahead.
Okay, here I go. It's actually not as bad as I thought. Cool. Now, let me get that door open for you. I'm afraid this time it's a one-way street, Mr. Cat. But where are you hiding?
In the closet.
There he is. Oh gosh, Fortune. You look a mess. You think he's all right?
The cat is fine. You can take it back to its owner. I will clean up any remaining mess.
Okay, see you soon.
What a mess. Oh, that's a mess.
It's Washington. Do you read me?
Loud and clear. What is your status?
We got a problem. I'm on the second floor and have a visual on multiple armed suspects entering our location. Most of them are heading your way, but I can hear some coming up the stairs.
Do not engage yet. Take your time and find the most advantageous location. I am coming up to have your back.
Glad to hear that, sir. I don't think I can hold him off for much longer, sir. We're in pig. Nowhere to hide. Ah!
What is your status?
I'm hit.
Remain calm. I am here.
Yeah.
That was intense. I need a breather.
Officer Washington, your performance today was impressive.
Thank you, sir. Means a lot coming from you.
You will be fine. It is only a superficial wound.
See? I've told you that cat brings luck. Isn't this just wonderful?
Lucky numbers. Well, good luck. Yeah, good work, officer. All right, Pickles. Time to talk.
City Hall is the decaying symbol of mismanagement and corruption. Detroit deserves a fresh start. And the only way to achieve that is to take the city private. Delta City, for our children.
In Delta City, we trust. FYI, you don't.
Getting so cold. Luckily, the previous owner didn't need this jacket anymore. And it has no bullet holes.
That's deep, Pickles. That's deep.
Greetings. Waiting for the movie screening.
Just browsing to find which movie would most enhance my nuke experience.
Has working with the police not made you change your ways?
I need to keep up appearances, otherwise I wouldn't be much use as an informer, now would I? Nah, tell me, what's the next job for the police's finest duo?
I need information on Spike's whereabouts.
That SOB. I'll never forgive him for what he did to Briggs. Luckily, there ain't much left of the Street Vultures after the bank heist. They're probably laying low. But now you mention it, I heard about a biker who had a crash near the riverbank just behind the mart. So, your best bet is to check out the scene of the accident, or maybe hit up a nearby mechanic to see if they know anything.
You really want justice for Briggs?
We owe him. But it's more about Daniel and Gale. And I think everyone will sleep better once those butchers are taken care of.
Any witnesses?
There's this crazy old bum who hangs out around there. He's nosy. Maybe he could help.
Are you positive that he escaped on the damaged motorcycle?
Not so much on it as with it. From what I gathered, the bike suffered more than just a dent. I'm guessing he must have dragged it to some nearby mechanic to get it back in shape. I think Ben's shop is the closest.
All right.
Thank you. You have given me all I need.
I know you're busy, but there's something that I need your help with.
I will not be involved in any illegal activity.
That's very presumptuous of you. I just need help finding a VHS tape in the rental place across the street. The title slipped my mind, and I assume you've got like a database or something in your head that'll make looking for it a breeze. So what do you say? Will you help me look for it?
If it helps you stay out of trouble, let us proceed.
Yeah, it'll solve all my problems. Let's go.
What are you looking for?
So there's this movie about a guy with a gun, and there's this bad guy who wants something. I'm pretty sure the title has some biblical reference in it.
You lack vital information on the subject.
Maybe he's talking about P. Roxy.
I don't care if OCP lost some money for once.
Okay, let's start searching. Remember, the title has something to do with the Bible, saints, cosmos, or let's start by checking the thriller and drama sections.
Should we ask the owner?
Forget him. He has no idea about movies. He thinks that Salamanca deserved the Golden Piston for the best picture.
I heard that. And it did.
Not gonna lie, this music's starting to grow on me.
Kind Shepherd?
Love that one. You know, that movie could have never happened. The director threw out the script after reading a couple of pages. Thankfully, his wife picked it out of the trash, and after reading it, she forced her husband to give it another look.
Everyone deserves a second chance.
Do we? I'm not so sure about that.
Alex Murphy was given a second chance.
But he... I mean, you really deserved it. Which is something I couldn't say about a lot of people. Anyway, I don't want to spoil the mood, but that's not the tape we're looking for.
Screw it.
Excuse me, we are conducting an investigation.
You can investigate the case of several tapes being overdue. Your main suspect is your friend over there.
Aw, man. Did he call us friends? Nice.
Garden of Earthly Delights.
Oh man, great movie. Very elegant. Panned by the critics, though. But the director is a badass. He personally showed up to one of those ceremonies to accept the award for the worst movie of the year.
not need to bow to outside pressure.
Easier said than done, my man.
Diamonds are made under great pressure.
Wait, do you think there's a diamond within me? Do you see my shine? I'm just messing with you. That was truly inspirational. But let's get back to it, because that's not our tape.
Nothing in thriller or drama.
Okay, how about you check in the sci-fi and action section? I'll have a look at horror.
Eve's Flower.
Beautiful depiction of violence in that one.
Do you think violence can be beautiful?
It's just shown with a different sensibility to what we're used to. Maybe because the guy's European. You know how they are. It's different. It's cool, is all I'm saying.
Recognizing beauty in something ugly is a unique feature.
Doesn't pay the bills, though. Then again, I don't have bills to pay anyway.
You know movies. There is value in that.
Yep. There's nothing better than a good movie. But we're still missing our tape.
Oh, man.
Celestial Decay.
Classic. Still waiting for a sequel. But the guy who did that one has never made a part two in his career. But he said that if he ever did, he'd do a sequel to that one. How do you feel about that? Sequels, remakes, comic book adaptations, etc.
Personally... let's just say better be done with passion and not a cash grab. Disney.
They give hope that there is more.
Yeah. Plus, you get to meet the characters you liked again. That's why I don't hate them. Anyway, risking to sound like a broken record, that's not the tape we're looking for.
Oh my god.
Hey, I think I found it. I messed up the title a little. It's called Me, Sire. But here it is. Isn't that the tape we're looking for? Tape? What? What tape?
You like movies? Do you want to shoot an action movie?
I think I'll wait till it comes out on VHS.
Lights, camera, action!
Ooh, crap! Crap! I need a hand over here!
Do you need assistance?
I'll torch you to a... now that breaks!
Killing so fast, we didn't get to see listen to the vocals.
First, I hear a bunch of movie puns, and then everyone starts shooting. It all happens so fast.
Where is Pickles?
He ran out the back door.
Where will I find him?
I don't know. But homeless or not, you still have to give an address to get a membership card. Try the computer. Maybe you'll find something there.
Or he just booked it just to get a free movie.
Who's gonna pay for all this?
VHS tapes. I grew up on this stuff. Pain in the ass to press rewinding the tapes. Took forever. Unlike nowadays, it's just a simple press of a button and bam, back to the beginning. And like in those days, it took a good, I'm gonna say, 3 to 2 minutes to rewind a tape before you can rewatch it again. And if you spam that rewind button, ooh, get ready for the film to just spew out of that tape. Like you're recovering from a hangover and you just go bleh. The VHS tape will do the same thing. Oh, Pickles, where are ya? Yep, that's a good representation of the what a VHS tape happens when you sped up the rewind too many times.
Some Torchhead saying that they were running away from the cops and went through that video store. They had a wad of drug money on them and didn't want the cops taking it, so they hid it in one of the VHS cases. I misheard the title, so I needed help.
That is not the kind of help I was willing to provide.
Come on, give me a break. I fucked up, I know. And I get that you're on a mission to save my life or something. With all that great advice of yours, diamonds are made under great pressure. I'm not a fucking diamond, okay? I'm a junkie. There's just one thing that I need right now.
Which is?
Nuke.
All I need right now is a fix. So, let me keep the money. You won't hear me asking about anything else.
Are you asking a police officer to leave you with money from Nuke Distribution?
I know you're a police officer first, but can't you be a friend this one fucking time?
Yep, I'll just do this again. Closing my eyes. 1, 2, 3.
I will leave the money with you if you spend it wisely.
That's cold-blooded, man. But thanks anyway. You're my savior, Tin Man. But what do I do with the money that I'm not supposed to spend on drugs? Like, what's the point?
Food. Clothing. Someplace to get a shower. What else? Yes, maybe some canned food. Keep you going when the winter hits. Yo, Ben.
Greetings, citizen.
Ah, the best cop in the hood is back. How can I be of service?
I am here in regards to a fugitive.
Oh, damn. What is wrong with this thing? I need to get that car down. or God knows what might happen. Can you help me out with this? It's new and I don't know where I put the manual.
Stand back.
Go on then. Let's see how it's done. I thought you knew how to bring that car down. Can't be that hard.
I'll bring it down with force. Probably broke it.
Start. Pop the hood. So, do you know what the problem is?
Someone put in the wrong transmission fluid.
The coil has been disconnected.
That would explain the car not starting.
Spark plugs are not the main culprit. There is no power. I detected an electric current inside the cooling tank. I recommend grounding it to fix the problem, but I am sure that you knew about that already.
What? I mean, I would never miss such a thing.
Battery is fine, stable, above 12 volts.
That's one thing checked off then. I'm guessing it's an easy fix. It started. We're on the money. Well done, Robocop. You are one serious Swiss Army man.
I am best at catching criminals. I should get back to it.
You said earlier you were looking for someone.
A biker. Have you repaired any motorcycles recently?
As a matter of fact, I did. This big chunky guy showed up. Bald head, big ears, and spiky beard. Wasn't really warm and cuddly, but he paid cash in advance. So why would I refuse?
Do you know the whereabouts of this individual?
I don't, but he asked me if I do paint jobs too. Then showed me a ripped out page that had a tattoo design on it. He asked me to spray a mean looking bird onto his gas tank.
Why do you think the design was intended for a tattoo?
The page he handed me had other graphics, which were clearly tattoo designs. And, as far as I remember, it had the address of a tattoo parlor that's close by printed on the bottom of the page.
What was the design you sprayed onto his motorcycle?
It was some sort of bird, but I don't know what it's called. I'm not a botanist. But it had a bald head.
An eagle?
Thank you for the information. Proceeding to the tattoo parlor.
Get points. Oh, this is gonna be good. There's like bouncing bullets, just like in the first movie. What was the second movie? I think it was the second movie.
Murphy, could you give us a hand? It's gotten real ugly in there.
What happened?
Can you believe this? A bunch of repeat offenders came up with a bright idea to storm the courthouse. For some reason, they think that if they destroy it, their prior convictions will go away. They took hostages and are now demanding both a 6,000 SUX and a plane to Acapulco.
Acapulco is a war zone.
I don't think these guys follow the news. But I'm afraid that it may be too late to rescue the hostages if we wait for SWAT.
If they want to fly into a war zone, I have first class tickets for them.
Yeah, let's go. Directive to protect the innocent.
Knocking at the wrong end. We ain't human.
Oh shit. That's cool. Oh my god, that's beautiful. Yeah, Murphy's Law. Sir, I wanna. Wait, man. Ah, what a way to go. It's a shame I can't see my work. Flash running out. Shh. Crap.
Oh god, heaven itself has sent you, Robocop. It was a nightmare.
Stay here. The police will come to question you.
Damn. One died. I gotta remember about my slow motion. This. I gotta remember that next time. Got them all. But one's dead. Lunch.
Hey, Robo, you showed them. It was a pleasure to work with you.
One hostage died, though. Okay. One hostage died, but let's just keep moving. Mm-hmm.
Full metal armor and you still want piercings. Hey, respect.
I am not here for that.
A tattoo, then. It'll really bring out that jawline.
Let's get deep and personal.
My body wears enough scars.
Believe me, you can never have enough of these puppies. Anyway, if you're not here for inking, what do you want?
A biker called Spike. I heard he was your customer.
I don't serve no bikers. Don't know who told you that, but it's a load of bull.
Are you denying making tattoos for the Street Vultures?
You've got no proof, cop. Now stay off my case. I need to get back to my work.
Alright, you asked for it.
What next? You're gonna try to tell me that I'm smuggling nuke in a red inker?
Do you?
You still here? I don't want my customers to confuse my parlor for an auto shop.
I found evidence of your connections to the biker gang.
I'm not telling you nothing, cop.
Spike and what is left of the Street Vultures are going down. It is your choice if you want to join them.
Ah, fuck. I told him not to come in here when he was so hot. He brought this on himself.
Where is he?
He's got a place nearby somewhere, but I don't know where exactly.
I am afraid this information is too vague.
His motorcycle must be parked outside. It's some sort of chopper. I don't know. You can check the plate number on that photo.
Wise choice for a scum artist.
Ugh. I can't concentrate with all those reflections bouncing off your armor.
Hey, Robocop. Mr. Mills would like to have a word. He's waiting in the car.
Come on.
It is an honor to finally meet the hero of the city in person. It's a shame that our basketball team can't fill us with similar pride. Yeah, just lost to Atlanta. Some say it's because of a lack of team players. Do you think it's that important? Being a team player?
Let's go over here.
Not every team is worth joining.
You have a very multifaceted outlook. Impressive. As for me, I have always valued team play. That was the way things were when my parents worked for the city. My grandfather used to tell me that this neighborhood was a great place for an evening stroll. Now it's different. Kuzak allows the city to be taken over by criminals. He can't stop it because he's not a team player. He fails to realize that OCP has given this city its most precious treasure. You. I want to work with you and OCP to improve this city. I want to take care of your interests. It's about time someone did. But to make it a reality, we would need your support. So, what do you think about getting involved in politics?
I follow politics, but I do not take sides.
So you allow others to use you, becoming a pawn. You are the symbol of the city. Everything you do, everything you say, has a political impact. No matter if you talk privately or publicly, you should choose what you want to represent. Incompetence and unaccountability, or partnership and determination. Only one of these paths leads Detroit to its former glory. You say you wouldn't join every team. So, let's create a team that you would want to be a part of. We have a common goal. Together, it will be easier to achieve it. Now, you'll have to forgive me. We're already late for another meeting. Now think about what we've discussed. about what we could do for this city. Together, as a team. I count on your support.
Jeez. I'm working both sides. First Amir and now this guy. The drama will never end. Well, hello, Spike.
Steal no joy with the broadcast! Yes, they're working in no time, Mr. Wendell. Sir? Yes, you won't screw it up.
He's using you, just like he used us. He hired us. We failed to deliver.
Talk about a sword. We had your chance. Now it's the Torchhead's turn. Deal with it, biker bitch. You weren't invited. Let's crush this tin can.
Suffering heavy blood loss. Operator, Wendell's trail leads to the outskirts west of town. Continuing pursuit.
Later, Spike. From the past, eh?
I hate the day shift.
Okay. No objectives. Good. Let's get out of here and look at this ghost from the past. Spooky.
First they can't even connect a few fucking cables, and now they don't even answer.
The new guy. He's waiting for some bigwig to show up. He's planning to do some psycho presentation.
And who is the bigwig?
That's what I want to find out.
Mr. W, we still have no contact with the funhouse.
I'm on the phone. We're ready. I understand, but please tell him that this is not a meeting that can be postponed. I see.
So, they ain't coming, right? Fucking suits!
Keep your anger to yourself, or I'll share mine with you.
Robo? Who's there?
Damn it.
Show yourself!
You'd better not.
As you wish, creep. You are under arrest. Come quietly.
Do you really believe that's what's gonna happen? Take care of him, boys. I'll meet you on the roof.
What's up, metal freak? Forget where you left your car?
You better go, Miss Ortiz. It seems there will be trouble.
Yeah, exactly. What's working?
Hey, you metal fucker! Wanna go next? Hey! Fleet total Robocap!
Oh no. Free snap out of it. What's that noise? That better be your heartbeat, so, Murphy.
Are you coming?
This is trippy and freaky. That's freaky.
Killed in the line of duty, were used to create some kind of a metal monster. I need to bury it to move forward with my life. Do you have a funeral suit that would fit that empty shell?
She's making me paranoid.
It thinks itself as human.
A world-class husband. A father. A cop. Did you hear? It's true. You're not one of us anymore.
You're not human.
And you're not a real cop. You're just the rotting remains of
Alex Murphy.
You're something that should
never
have been. Something
that should
not exist. We have to fix you. We have to erase
you.
And we will. Just come to
us.
Come to the rooftop.
We're
waiting.
Where's the rooftop? Hey, the rooftop. Well, mother...
Badge.
It's the crap that is stuck to our shoe. A cuckoo egg planted by OCP. We need to clear our station of this shit. We must smash that thing. Fire at will.
The what?
You're not one of us. You feel that too, don't?
Oh, I'm tripping. Oh, that's where why I was seeing that painting before. It's right here.
You're back. There's coffee in the kitchen. Do you like it? The mug.
Dad, can you fix the camera? I think something's broken. Hey, you fixed it! Remember, I'm playing a game this afternoon?
Dad wouldn't miss it, would he?
Pick me up at the station. I'll grab my gear.
Do you really have to go? You look so sexy in that uniform. Why won't you stay a little longer?
Get in with Murphy's place. I'm jealous. Ah, crap.
Why are you here? Do you not love your family?
No attachments. No leverage. This is a gift.
Don't take him away from me!
Everyone wants to be back home with their families. Be back home.
Welcome, Chopper. Let's take a stroll through your old home.
Damn straight.
Go back. Go on with your life like nothing happened. This is a one-family house built on GM Industries. It's for sale because the head of the family to which it belonged was shot in the head. Your family has forgotten. Why do you want to remember them? You attach yourself to something that is the weakest in you. To the part that's still human. Have you thought it over? Why not make me an offer? Why carry this burden? What is your sacrifice worth? Holding on to them makes you weak. Destroy them. Destroy them before they destroy you.
Get me out of here.
Alex Murphy, the one and the only. I'm here because you have something that belongs to me. You have my badge. Lois gave it to me. Lois is hurt because of you, because you keep insisting that you're something that you're not. You think that you are a fusion of me in this metal armor, but you're not me, not even a part of me. I'm dead and I want to finally rest, but you won't let me. Your delusions keep tormenting me and my family. You need to let us go. I want my badge back. I have it, so I remember. Remember what? The lie? Lewis knows us. She would not lie. Give it to me. It's mine. But, Lewis, I want it back. This is my badge. Then I'll have to take it back myself.
Are strong enough to take him. Don't forget you have a partner who's counting on you. Take this gift. Don't forget who you are. Alex Murphy.
Get up, Robo.
Get up, for God's sake. That's it, Robo. Keep going.
Where's the chopper? The cops will be here any...
Wendell Antonowsky?
Haven't you had enough yet?
You are under arrest. You have the right to remain silent.
Relax. I'm not your enemy. If I were, you would have already...
You have the right to an attorney.
I wanted to help you. Release you from the burden of your past life, of your memories. But you don't want to lose them, right? Now I get it.
Anything you say may be used against you.
I can give you back those memories. All of them. We should help each other. We have the same boss! Police!
God damn it, you again?
People need to see this.
This is real.
Cuff him. He is a cop killer.
Hands behind your back.
Can you hand me my lighter? It's a family heirloom. I wouldn't want to lose it.
You mean this trinket? It'll be safer in the prison depository. You'll pick it up yourself in, I don't know, 150 years?
Plenty of time for rehabilitation.
These summons is real. These summons is real.
Top story. Wendell Antonowsky, the infamous...
Oh, it's real.
...has been apprehended today. Robocop was able to capture Antonowsky, as reported by an eyewitness, Channel 9 Samantha Ortiz. Unfortunately, no footage of the event has emerged. Robocop's efforts have prompted a public debate regarding his status as a human being. Here's a statement from John Mills, a candidate for the mayor's office in the upcoming mayoral election.
Today, Robocop has done more for this city than the current administration has done in its entire term. That's why I feel that it's time to give something back. If elected, I will be advocating to grant Robocop the status of a free, living human being. That's right. Vote Mills, vote Robocop.
Staying on the topic of OCP, the CEO of Omni Consumer Products suffered a heart attack earlier today. The self-made entrepreneur has been taken to the Gibson Memorial Hospital for observation. His condition is stable. We wish you a speedy recovery.
Wendell's in prison and the old man is on his way out. Could this day be any better?
Geez, Steph, don't you have any respect?
Here's the man of the hour.
Congrats, Robo. You caught that bastard for what he did to Lewis.
We are not done yet.
Murphy, come talk to me after you're done with your evaluation.
Ugh. Yeah, Wendelin in my hands. I was like, no way. Am I tripping? Am I still tripping? Because then it was real. And the lights are back on.
I just knew he'd be the one to bust that asshole.
Glad we have Murphy on our team.
Yeah.
Are you having problems getting a hospital appointment? Are you tired of being at the mercy of those never-ending waiting lists? Do you feel powerless? It's time to take the control back. Take part in the Family Heart Raffle and play the odds. A single ticket is your chance to win a mystery medical service. Anything from a dental appointment to a knee transplant. Don't miss the opportunity.
For only $9.99, I want a visit to the pediatrician.
Fingers crossed for a prostate exam.
A heart transplant? Here I go.
Don't wait. Buy a ticket to the Family Heart Raffle today. Selling your winning ticket is illegal and will be prosecuted to the fullest extent of the law.
Yeah, I think the waiting list is better because it's a mystery. So what if you when I get surgery or something. Instead, they're just gonna, I don't know, do a dental check on your teeth. Yeah, sounds like a ripoff.
Is that the TV personality I keep seeing on television? Have a seat, Robo. Something not many people know about me. I used to be a car mechanic before I landed this job.
Is that supposed to put us at ease, Morgan?
Yeah. Oops. Still got an A.
Congratulations on catching Wendell. You seem to constantly be front page news. Not only that, your situation has become a topic of public debate. I imagine that could take a toll on anyone. How are you dealing with other people trying to determine your identity for you?
Oh, man.
Someone is fighting for my rights.
That's probably the healthiest way of looking at it. But the status of a human would make you an autonomous being. It opens many doors. Being given human rights would let you fully take control of your life. Is that something that you'd actually want?
Yes, I deserve it.
And why is that?
I am human.
The idea of granting you human rights is a very important issue, but no more important than the main reason for today's session. Many people might not be aware of that, but I have the whole report on the heavy glitches that you suffered before capturing Wendell. The only other time you've experienced anything similar was during the slaughterhouse incident. That's when your partner was wounded. Now, you were fighting the person responsible for it. Do you think the severity of those glitches is caused by the intense feelings that you have towards either of them?
It's the damn lighter. It's the lighter, come on.
My partner is important. I needed to do right by her.
I know how close she is to you. Let's dig a little deeper. Your typical glitches are triggered by sensory stimulation, similar to how most people experience memories when exposed to particular sights, sounds, or smells. But this wasn't the case with the other glitches that you experienced recently?
No, they triggered randomly.
That's what I suspected. And now tell me, what did they seem like to you when you experienced them?
Nightmares.
I think we're onto something. Your usual glitches were making you recall memories. No more harmful than remembering your wedding day when hearing Mendelssohn's march. We have to differentiate them from those severe malfunctions that you experienced in the slaughterhouse and at the mall. Those latter ones are the real problem, and we need to get to the bottom of it. But I think I've gathered quite a lot of valuable data, and at our next session, I'll present my conclusions.
Hey, Robo, could you stop by the cells on your way to Reed? Someone there wants to speak to you.
I should have known. Ooh, that was one trippy emotional roller coaster, am I right? At least we got Wendelin. I don't know about Clover, but we got Wendelin. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to leave a like, comment, and subscribe for the next episode. Now that I have Wendelin, what's next? Well, guess we'll both find out in the next episode. Until then, this is Desert Rock Gaming saying goodbye and have a great day.